That's what I've got.
Yay! And so, welcome to the second day of Broadway Evolved Homeschool Edition. Maybe. For those of you who kind of don't know who we are, we're basically an NYC intensive that has turned educational training upside down. And we bring the best of the best, which of course, Al Silber's here today. And I have to say, she came to us last year for our summer intensives, and you all could not stop talking about the nuggets of wisdom, and just everything about her is brilliant, and the way that she's able to teach as an artist. So today, listen up, keep taking your notes. I'm so excited to have you guys here. And if you're bored because you have nothing to do, go to BroadwayEvolved.com and see what we're all about. And this is my makeshift, Al, isn't this ridiculous? This is my makeshift homeschool.
I love it. I love it. I love it. And I think that all of you're in my bedroom right now. And
yeah.
We are turning and transforming all of our spaces. And I think that the metaphor of transforming our homes into more expansive spaces within as well as without is where we're going to start today.
Yes, I'm leaving it to you.
Love
everyone,
you, Lexi.
Educators, students, we'll see you back here tomorrow, 12 every day, Eastern Daylight Time. Al, take it away.
Woo-hoo! Okay, bye. See you soon. Hi, learners. I am so excited to join you. And this is going to be a creativity masterclass. So here's how this is going to go down. We're going to do a couple of exercises that you can do right now. You can write down later to do later in the week or whenever you're feeling creatively blocked or stuck, or just that you are so overwhelmed with everything that's going on that you need any kind of outlet to express yourself. I am here and I've got you. We're going to go through the exercises live today, and you'll be able to reference back to this video. But I will also, after we hang up, I will post the exercises in screenshots that you can hold and reference and get in your phones or get onto your computers for future reference. After we do the exercises, I'll open it up to like a little bit of Q&A, and then I've got some really fun surprises at the end, some giveaways, and an absolute invitation to keep the conversation going with me and, of course, Broadway Evolved. So let's get started. Today, all you're going to need is to grab a pen and a paper, a journal. It can be fancy. It can be a napkin. It doesn't matter, as long as you can just get your ideas down. And what I want to express is something that I've always wanted to express to you guys, which is that everybody is an artist. It doesn't mean that you necessarily even have to have an art form. It doesn't mean that it's the thing you declare as your major in college or the thing that's on your tax return if you're an adult. So I think one of the most important things to embrace today is that everybody has a creative being inside of them. And when we were younger, when we were children, we never censored that kid. That kid played in the sandbox and dressed up and played pretend, and they were able to play out and express all of the things that they wanted and needed and could envision being real about the world. And as we grow up, we're told to be realistic, we're told to have smaller dreams, or sometimes other people in our lives are so threatened by our power and our light that they give us incentives to dull ourselves in order to make them comfortable. And today, all of that be gone. So by this point, I hope you've gotten your pen and paper, and we're going to start with the exercises. So here we go. Everybody ready? Okay. Exercise number one is called adding up a series of one-digit numbers fast. That's all it is. This is just like a giant shake, cocktail shaker for your brain. It's telling your creative brain to turn off the sensor. The sensor is the devil, okay? The sensor is going to kill all of your creativity. It's the inner director that's telling you that what you're doing while you're performing isn't good. It's the inner editor that's editing as you write. It's the eighth grade art teacher that's telling you that those colors don't go together. Today, their voice doesn't matter, and we're gonna do a really simple exercise with numbers on the other side of our brain, our logical side of our brain, just to get things moving. So here's what I want you to do. I want you to quickly add up the following numbers. 4 plus 7 plus 9. 2 + 2 + 8. Great. This exercise compels you to continually change the information that you're having to work with and remember. It shakes your brain. It kills the sensor. And as you're adding up the numbers, your grand total constantly changes, and you have to arrive at the next total. You have to focus solely on the current total and the next number that you're adding, right? It's so simple. It's so easy. It's a great place to start, especially if you're feeling super stuck or depressed or in a rut. So there are very few mental exercises where focus and continually evolving information play such an important part, which is why this one is really helpful in training your mind to remember essential information while deleting all of the other data that just doesn't matter in that moment. Here's a couple others. 4 + 7 + 3 + 9 3 + 9 + 5 + 8 2 + 6 + 3 + 3 Great. So the next time that you are just sitting around in quarantine, instead of putting on your sensor hat, whip out your wallet, pick up a dollar bill, and try to, as quickly as you can, add all of the single digit serial numbers together on the back of that dollar bill. It'll get your brain right into open and ready to play space. Great job. Okay. Exercise number two. Exercise number two is something that we did live at Broadway Evolve, and it's absolutely one of my favorite exercises in the world. I'm going to quickly show you a chart. So do you guys remember magic circles? This is one of my favorites, and all you need is a pen and paper. So here's the gist. You want to draw, as I'm explaining the exercise, you want to draw a series of at least 12 blank circles without allowing your inner sensor to evaluate what you're producing. They don't even have to be beautiful circles, but I just want you to see that it should look something like this. I'm gonna do a little flip. It should look something like that, okay? I'll give a screenshot of this when we're done. Okay, so start drawing those circles right now as I explain the exercise. So that when we do the timer, you're gonna be ready to work. Your goal is to fill in as many of these circles with somewhat recognizable objects as you can during an allotted short period of time. It can be anything that's conventionally circular, like a soccer ball or an eye, a lollipop, a planet, but it can also be a window peephole into another universe. The possibilities are totally limitless and no drawing ability is required. You can also draw outside of the circles, but use the circle as your base. There's no rules here. Okay, so now I'm hoping that you've drawn at least 12 circles, and I'm gonna count down for 120 seconds. Don't stop, just go right now. Great. So as you're drawing, I'm gonna keep coaching you here. This exercise may sound simple, but you'll find after you get through the obvious basketballs and smiley faces of the world, peace signs and things, you'll have to start thinking a little bit differently to fill the rest of them out. You could even do this in a group with some of your other coworkers or your friends or colleagues or classmates. And you can get inspired by how other people approach this challenge. Either way, it's sure to get your brain feeling looser in the end and really ready to tackle whatever challenge you have in front of you. This combined with the numbers exercise, are you drawing still? I hope you're still drawing. Good. This combined with the number exercises shakes both sides of your brain, telling the right and left hemisphere to get ready to work and get ready to play. And so by this point, time is up. And I want to see what you came up with. So can you write what you came up with in the comments, and I'll announce some of the good ones. Let me see. What'd you come up with? Let me know. What have we got? A globe. Beautiful. A globe. Beautiful. We're all thinking globe. A light bulb. Love that. A cube. Ooh, very good. A sunflower. Planets. These are great, you guys. A hamster. I wish I could see that. Please DM that to us. A fish. A park. A tree growing up. Guys, these are so, so good. So this is exactly what you can do. And anytime you're feeling stuck, you just draw 12 circles, you set a timer, you go, and you're ready to play. Okay. Exercise number 3. Now this one is about as simple as it gets, but it's deceptively simple. It's just called keep it simple. Problems are often obscured by an overload of information. Sound familiar right now? Right? I'm sure a ton of us are completely maxed out on information overload, way too much information, some of which doesn't even seem dependable anymore, coming from the news and from our social media feeds. What should we do in a crisis like this? But this isn't just true in a crisis. Sometimes an overload of information comes from too many creative ideas, too many directions to go in. And this exercise helps clarify and isolate the challenge we all face as creatives by spending time understanding and defining the exact task. So here's the exercise. Can you simplify your idea, pitch, story, project, or thought down to 10 words? Can you do it in 5 words? Can you do it in 3 words or even 1? Here's the project. The writer Ernest Hemingway famously laid down a challenge to his contemporaries at the time to write a complete story in only 6 words. What he came up with was agonizingly beautiful. For sale, baby shoes, never used. Try it. Or update this to a Twitter challenge and write an entire story in only 140 characters. It will get you to the absolute kernel and essence of what you're trying to say, accomplish, or do. And once you've established that, you can respond to just that. And I think what will emerge is that you'll start to see that under the umbrella of one giant idea, you've got 3 clear ideas. And you can go forward because you've identified it in as streamlined as language as possible. Keep it simple. Okay, so the 4th exercise of 5, we're almost done, is called try translating. Ideas are greatly stimulated by the process of transformation. Converting things from one creative form or medium into another creative form or medium. And they can guide our thoughts in totally new and exciting directions if we allow them to. So the Russian artist Vasily Kandinsky translated classical music into abstract paintings by playing what he saw as the music emerged. And he selected different colors to signify the varying emotions that the music provoked. But you don't have to do it with color. You could do it with line or the intensity. You could do it through movement. You could do it with your voice. He also invented something he called a machine of the mind that he felt almost immediately translated the musical sounds into instructions for his paintings. So when he was stuck, he turned to a completely different art form to motivate him in the art form that he was famous for. So here are your at-home projects. 1, I want you to translate the following words into font or typography. It can be a complete work of art. It can use the actual letters. It can use letters in a different language, or you can completely create your own language of color and space and shape. But I want you to convert the following 4 words into individual works of art. Lazy. Happy. Soft. Loud. Great. I'd love to know what you come up with. Make sure that you send us some great screenshots. At home project number 2 under try translating. Play a piece of abstract, totally wordless music and paint, draw, or move to what you hear. So move the pen, paint brush or pencil without any concept of your finished product. In fact, it might even be useful for you to know that you're going to toss the finished product away in the recycling bin when you're done. Or turn on the music and move your body without the concept of anybody watching you. You could also move your voice along in a way that doesn't necessarily seem like singing. It could just seem to be making noise. All this is doing is generating ideas. There's a very famous concept of what it means to be an artist artisan, meaning that you work hard at art, right? And really what that means is, think about going into a wood shop, right? And you have a piece of wood that somewhere inside there is your great creative masterpiece. And the only way to get there is by creating wood chips to get closer and closer and closer. And the wood chips themselves are not works of art. They're evidence of your effort. And sometimes it's not about getting to the ultimate goal. It's about the act and the holy work of creating more wood chips. So that's what these exercises are doing. Now, the third under Try Translating project is this. I want you to make a list of five of your absolute favorite songs. Now, these don't have to be wordless. These can have lyrics and evoke real linguistic emotions in you. And I want you to set aside 20 minutes to do this next exercise. I want you to physically embody each one of these songs into one singular physical gesture that expresses how it makes you feel. Total and complete emotional accuracy really matters. So the difference between a gesture like this and a gesture like this is going to mean all the difference and make all the difference to the exact feeling that you are expressing with your body. What this is doing, again, is taking different parts of the human form, taking your logic, your emotion, and the physical, and marrying them together in ways that you might not reach for first when it comes to expressing yourself. And I think that what you'll find is that if you try different kinds of art forms and cross them over, each one of the other pools will become fuller and fuller and richer and richer. Now, this exercise, especially the last one, the one where you embody your favorite song, is quite evocative. So make sure that you give yourself a little bit of time to warm up and down and put a little bit of space around this exercise so that you don't max out and you don't overload yourself or overstimulate yourself. Okay, finally, the very last exercise of today. Now, this is called detective work, and it's cribbed from Julia Cameron's The Artist's Way, which is an amazing project to take on right now, should any of you be looking for a guidebook and how to sort of nurture the creative soul, and especially healing the creative soul that may be broken in some way. I'm just gonna quote her directly. "Many blocked people are actually very powerful and creative personalities who have been made to feel guilty about their own strengths and gifts. Without being acknowledged, they are often used as batteries by their families and friends who feel free to both use their creative energies and disparage them. When these blocked artists strive to break free of their dysfunctional systems, they are often urged to be sensible when such advice is not appropriate for them. Made to feel guilty for their talents, they often hide their own light under a bushel for fear of hurting others. Instead, they hurt themselves. A little sleuth work is in order to restore the person we have abandoned, ourselves. When you complete the following phrases, you may feel strong emotion as you retrieve memories and misplaced fragments of yourself. Allow yourself to free associate for a sentence or so with each phrase." So, this is the exercise. I want you to, in your journal or piece of paper, take down the following prompts, which, by the way, I will also have in a screenshot after we hang up. And I want you to set aside some time to, as she says, free associate answers to all of these prompts. What they're doing is they're doing detective work. They're excavating memories, sensory perceptions, things that are important to you that you've long put away, and they're bringing them to the surface again. And it's a very evocative exercise that the more time you dedicate to it and the quieter you get inside the exercise, the more you're going to get out of it. But it's a very generative exercise and hopefully restorative too. So I'll just say a couple of them right now and give you a little bit of time to think about it. And like I said, I'll have all of the questions listed in a screenshot at the end of the class. My favorite childhood toy was... The best movie I saw as a kid was... If it weren't too late, I would... I secretly enjoy. If it didn't sound so crazy, I'd write or make a... My parents think artists are... I don't do it too much, but I really enjoy... Great. Just remember that growth is an erratic movement. It's always 2 steps forward, 1 step back. Sometimes 10 steps forward, 12 steps back. But remember that and be gentle and kind with yourself. Okay, those are the exercises for the day, my loves. I wanted to finish up with just a little bit of a pep talk. A real reminder to reconnect, to continue to gather virtually just like this, to breathe, to, when it's appropriate, put down your screens and connect with yourself, and really don't be afraid of the quiet. Remember who you are helping or serving by staying at home. I very rarely talk about this, but I do think it's a really important thing to say that I am an immune compromised person. I have an autoimmune disease. I talk about it rarely, but I'm not hiding it. But one of the things that I think is really important is that you're seeing me right now. I'm energetic. I have an invisible illness. And I look to be the pinnacle of health at the prime of my life. But when they talk about the people that have underlying conditions, when they talk about the people that are vulnerable, by you staying home, you are helping to protect not only the elderly and the visibly sick, but people like me who you may not ever suspect. And I just wanna say that I really appreciate that, and you never, never know the private battles. So it's really important for all of us to keep doing our part. And ultimately, I encourage you all to use this time. You know, one of the many things I often say in my books, I write a lot about grief. My second book, White Hot Grief Parade, is about the passing of my father at 18. And one of the many things that I talk about is that we cannot change reality. I cannot change the fact that I lost my father early. But I can take that reality and see the good in it and use the gifts that are presented for that very reason. Use this time wisely and ask the universe what we as a collective society and we as individuals can learn from it, and how we may grow, and above all, how we may serve. So that's my little pep talk. I wanted to just also say a couple of things to keep the conversation going. So one, teaching. If you're interested in more remote teaching with me, I'm offering my services to everyone from Broadway Evolved for a whopping 30% discount until the end of April. And every single penny is going to serve my community in the Actors Fund. The link to my teaching page will be linked in the story, but it's alexandrasilber.as.me. And you enter BE discount at checkout, and voila. Any additional questions, email me directly at alexandrasilber@gmail.com. And I'm also humbly suggesting that in your quarantine, you might want to read my books. You can order the hard copies online and I'll happily sign them later. But I also might suggest letting me read them to you via audible.com. And with that in mind, I'm announcing a little giveaway, okay? So today only, I am offering 3 totally free download coupons from Audible Downloads for your choice of any book, but might I humbly suggest After Anna Tevka or White Hot Grief Parade, and I can spend a couple of hours reading a beautiful story to you. This is available to the first 3 people to answer the following questions correctly in my DMs at Al Silbs. So those questions are: what are the names of all Tevye's daughters? 2, how long does the World Health Organization say we need to wash our hands for? And 3, what is my cat's full name? Good luck, and above all, happy creative quarantine. Remember, everyone is an artist, and all of us can benefit if elected to grow in unimaginable directions during seemingly fallow times. Grab at joy, you guys. Believe in your capacity to endure and expect the unexpected. Don't give up. I'll see you soon. And all my love and health to you and yours.